Impulse Space, a US startup founded in 2021 that builds space tugs, has set its sights on the moon. In this video, I'll cover their recent announcement about plans to go to the moon and beyond. The company has designed two space tugs called Helios and Mira. Their Helios Kickstage is a high-powered tug that can send payloads from low Earth to geosynchronous orbit in a matter of hours. This is a tug that plays a key role in their ambitions for the moon. Mira, on the other hand, is a smaller, lighter, and more agile space tug that's great for precision maneuvering and operations such as rendezvous and proximity tasks. Think orbital debris, satellite inspection, and refueling missions. The Mira vehicle has deployed in space twice, in 2023 and 2024, with a third Mira flight planned soon. As an aside, the recently launched Haven demo mission from Vast Space uses a Mira engine, so hardware from Impulse Space is currently in orbit and operational at the time this video was made. The startup was founded by Tom Mueller, who was SpaceX's employee number one. He designed the Merlin engine that powers Falcon 9 rockets. Not content with moving payloads between orbits around the Earth, Impulse Space has set its sights on the moon, using its powerful Helios space tug to do a translunar injection burn to send Helios and the lander heading towards the moon. Once it's close to the moon, the Helios tug performs lunar orbit insertion and circularization burns before separating from the lunar lander. Then the lander performs the descent burn and finally a landing burn to safely arrive on the lunar surface. But why is Impulse Space doing this? What are they hoping to achieve? And just how ambitious are Impulse Space's plans? Let's find out. Impulse Space's lofty goals. If you followed this channel for any length of time, you're already aware of a number of other companies sending lunar landers to the moon, from Intuitive Machines, iSpace, Firefly Aerospace, and Astrobotic, plus various lunar landers from India, Japan, Israel, and China. It seems like every country, space agency, and a number of private companies have set their sights on the moon. In the case of NASA, space startups can bid for commercial lunar payload services contracts. This program is commonly abbreviated to CLPS, which I'll use in the rest of the video. This is a way for private companies to bid for NASA contracts to land payloads on the moon's surface. In fact, with Jared Isaacman's plan for NASA, this approach to contract space startups is likely to extend across the solar system, but let's keep our eyes on the moon for now. Of the four CLPS missions, only one was 100% successful, Firefly's Blue Ghost mission. One Intuitive Machines mission, IM-1, was partially successful, with a second, IM-2, a failure. Astrobotic's lunar lander, due to a fuel leak, burnt up in the atmosphere shortly after it was deployed. So, Impulse Space, sensing an opportunity, is entering the lunar lander market. In fact, the company already has one crucial piece of hardware already developed and under testing. Helios, the space tug responsible for transporting the lunar lander to the moon's orbit. This powerful assist allows the lander to carry heavier payloads such as rovers, habitats, and even, potentially, nuclear power stations. Serious equipment, not just a lightweight sensor or experiment. Their spacecraft is capable of landing 3 tons of equipment to the moon's surface. That puts it in direct competition with Blue Origin's Mark 1 lunar lander, which can also land 3 tons. Impulse Space advantages. Impulse Space's expertise in engines cannot be understated. Their founder developed the engine that dominates the launch market, putting 85% of all global payload mass into space. Impulse Space is actively working on the lander, with the first launch expected in 2028. The Helios space tug is expected to launch on its first mission next year. The company builds its components in-house, streamlining the process and leading to rapid prototyping, building and testing of new or upgraded components. Lunar lander unveiled. Recently, Impulse Space unveiled their proposed lunar mission architecture. Let's go over the concept of operations to understand how the company plans to land cargoes on the moon. Step 1. Helios kickstage and lander deploy from the launch vehicle. After deployment from the launch vehicle, an initial burn is made towards the moon. Step 2. After lunar orbit insertion burn, the lander separates from Helios. Step 3. Lander performs a descent burn to exit lunar orbit. And Step 4. descent to the surface with an arrival burn for a soft landing. If all goes well, the lunar lander makes a soft landing on the surface shortly afterwards. To the moon and beyond. Tom Mueller, the founder and CEO, wrote a blog post on the company's website explaining the rationale for going to the moon and beyond. He says we haven't fulfilled the promise of the original space race era. We don't have flying cars or jetpacks. Star Trek hasn't come true yet. Impulse Space, he said, was founded to accelerate a future beyond Earth. Impulse Space's lunar vision. Impulse Space are passionate about building and contributing to a thriving and sustainable presence on the moon. They also believe the natural resources of the moon are worth exploring. They have identified a critical gap in the lunar cargo delivery market. This gap is for mid-sized payloads, ranging from half a ton up to 13 tons in mass. This mass range includes habitats, rovers, power systems, mining rigs, and more. The CLIPS program is currently limited to quite small payloads, while human landing systems target 20 plus tons at the minimum. To rapidly build out lunar infrastructure, additional new lunar landers that can serve this mid-sized market are required. That's where Impulse Space's lunar lander comes in. Because of the high delta V capability that the Helios space tug achieves, no in-space refueling is required. Multi-ton payloads can be delivered to the moon's surface fast without the added complexity of docking and refueling required for the larger human landing systems offered by SpaceX and Blue Origin. Impulse Space believes they can transport 6 tons of payload to the moon's surface every year, starting in 2028. That requires 2 missions since each lander is limited to a maximum of 3 tons per lander. Impulse's edge. Impulse Space emphasizes their flight-proven hardware that de-risks the mission. The High Delta V Helios vehicle is scheduled to launch next year, so should be ready in plenty of time for the 2028 missions. Vertically integrated systems, not just engines, but star trackers and structures. Impulse Space has a track record of designing, building, and deploying engines quickly. As they showed by developing the Mira engines, from clean sheet design to deployment in less than 15 months, their lunar lander engine will be throttleable and restartable. The engines use nitrous oxide and ethane bipropellant system, the same propellant as their Mira vehicle that's flown in space already. This stirrable propellant doesn't suffer from boil-off concerns that affects engines that use cryogenic fuels, such as Blue Origin, Intuitive Machines, and SpaceX Starship vehicles. This allows the Impulse Space lander to loiter in orbit for long periods of time, or even to have an extended cruise phase without losing any fuel. A problem for competitors unless they develop complicated zero boil-off technologies or continuously top up propellants in orbit. While this propellant choice has several advantages, it's only fair to include disadvantages. Compared to cryogenic fuels, it has lower fuel efficiency, which in practice means more propellant needs to be carried to deliver the same delta V and a heavier lander design. Ethane, while storable, is also flammable, so has to be handled carefully. In addition, it is not refuelable from local lunar resources, unlike both Blue Origin's Mark II and SpaceX's Starship vehicles, which are designed to be reusable, reducing operational costs. While a good propellant for mid-sized landers, it doesn't scale to larger vehicles. Higher performing vehicles like the Mark II from Blue Origin, and especially SpaceX's Starship, will dominate for large cargo transfers to the moon. Upcoming events. Impulse's first mission to the moon is planned for 2028. The first launch and deployment of the Helios space tug, a critical element of their moon plans, should be in 2026. What do you think of Impulse Space's plans and vision for the moon? Is their use of nitrous and ethane, a stirrable bipropellant, an advantage or not? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.